Russian launch vehicles are named after the payload that they carry or the spacecraft they launch. With a curriculum vitae that includes over 1,700 manned and unmanned launches, the Soyuz rocket is the most frequently used launch vehicle in the world. The rocket consists of three stages that provide thrust at various points in the flight until the Soyuz capsule finally settles into orbit around the Earth. Right at the top of the structure are the manned Soyuz capsule and the emergency rescue system. Soyuz 2 or GRAU Index 14A14 is a modernized version of the Soviet Soyuz rocket. Compared to the previous versions of the Soyuz, the first stage boosters and two core stages feature uprated engines with improved injection systems. Soyuz 2 is often flown with an upper stage, which allows it to lift payloads into higher orbits, such as Monia and geosynchronous orbits. Soyuz 2 rockets were first launched from Site 31 at the Baikonur Cosmodrome and Site 43 at the Plesetsk Cosmodrome. Launch facilities shared with earlier RAU-7 derived rockets, including the Soyuz U and Monia. Commercial Soyuz 2 flights are contracted by Starsom and have launched from Site 31 at Baikonur Cosmodrome and Ensemble de Lancement Soyuz, which has been built at the Center Spatial Guyana on the northern coast of South America. Specifically for its use in Vostochny, the Soyuz 2 family was expected to get modest internal updates to enable the fueled rocket to remain on the launch pad for up to 100 hours and withstand the rigors of transportation up to 10,000 kilometers from its manufacturing plant in Samara to the Russian Far East. Soyuz rockets built for launches from Vostochny would also be equipped with special valves to drain excess propellant outside of the Mobile Service Tower, MBO, to prevent dangerous concentration of oxygen vapors in its interior. According to the original plan, the Soyuz 2, also known as Soyuz 2K and Soyuz M, would sport a brand new R0124 or 14D23 closed cycle engine on its third stage, an all digital flight control system with terminal guidance system. All the upgrades combined would increase the payload of the vehicle by 1,200 kg in comparison with the base launcher. Thanks for watching. See you the next videos.